You know, historically, markets really were only about getting food to people, food that is produced in a way that people can get behind. People want to know how the vegetables were grown, whether or not they were sprayed. And so these are things that people really care about. And the farmers market is the place where they can get those answers and get to the heart of where their food is coming from. The best way to understand this is to compare it to a grocery store experience. And, you know, people don't tend to go to the grocery store to learn about the source of their food and talk to the people that grew the food. They don't have that opportunity. And so people come to a farmer's market because they do have that face-to-face opportunity to connect to the people that are responsible for producing their food.
Firstly, I always try to come to a farmer's market to shop local, to support the local merchants, the local farmers.
The idea of being able to like get a basic need met, like getting groceries, and then also have sort of like an opportunity to socialize with friends. And this market in particular is really family friendly. And so it's really fun to bring my kids here too.
And a place like this that brings people together, where we can nourish ourselves, where we can bring our families together, where we can check in with others, that makes a huge difference to people's days. To start your Saturday, to start your weekend like this, I think it just puts people on the right step, and that's important.
I pretty much buy as much food as I can at the farmers market. I hardly shop at the grocery store, and yeah, I would encourage everyone to do the same.
It feels kind of humbling to be learning about farmers and see that there's this massive heritage, this tradition, almost like this torch that people have been carrying to keep the production of food alive in a certain region that, you know, for myself, I feel I was very disconnected to. And that's, but to get to learn about that and get to see that and understand that when someone shows up at this market and there's that, those items sitting in a basket on a table, to know how much has gone into making that moment happen is profound.
I hadn't really thought much about where food came from. I mean, I had on some level, but not very deeply. But in getting to know the stories of local farmers, I got to know more and more about how hard farmers work to try to achieve that and what sort of things were missing that they needed to be able to be successful. And one of the things that were missing was good infrastructure, a place where they could gather and sell their products to the public. And do it in an ethical and clear and honest way.
Round two.
We started kind of like starting a conversation about farmers market and farmers and local food. And I think that started kind of bringing forward this alignment of people who are actually growing the food themselves. And there was this alignment there.
This really is a celebration of local. We've handpicked the vendors because they support local agriculture, because they make an effort to use the products of the farmers who are here. And then local artists and artisans and musicians. It really is a celebration of local agriculture and just this region.
I know a lot of people think that it's the farmers that have been doing this, and yes, we've been putting in lots of hours, but there have been an amazing crew who have stepped up and done so many amazing things and spent hours away from their family and have just done things beyond what we could have ever expected.
I think what happens too is that because we see everyone else doing all of these great things, it makes you want to jump in and do more things, and it makes you want to be a part of things, and it makes you want to, you know, do kids crafts at 9 o'clock before the market day, because you want kids to be able to like come to market and enjoy those things, or develop new community relationships so that we have people coming to do programming, or we have new vendors wanting to join the market, mm-hmm. because
I think they feel that energy. They feel that excitement.
Yeah.
It's very dynamic. It's evolving. It's just fun to be a part of something with that kind of energy.
The market, outdoors and indoors, for me, has just a big smile over it. People are happy. People are talking. Customers are loving it. Customers are saying how good it feels to walk in here. And I think that just says all. That was our goal. That was where we wanted to be, is that it was a nice place for everybody to be.
We realized from research and talking to customers that, like, customers, when they go to the market, are the majority of them are looking for those farmers. So there was alignment there on the customer end, you know? So you had farmers aligning with each other, and then you had customers aligning with farmers.
My people, the ones that, like, are also concerned about sustainable food systems, are finding us here at the market, and they're curious about my, like, everything we do at the farm is a little bit different. Like, you don't find what we grow in a grocery store. So it's heritage livestock, specialty mushrooms. So that feedback loop is really important, like the chance to actually talk with the people who are enjoying our food, why they're enjoying it, the questions they have, how they're using it. Like, that's the important piece of the farmer's market for me.
It's really easy to go to a farmer's market. It's really easy to talk to somebody who grows your food directly and to have a relationship with those people. And I think that's the most important thing that we should be focusing on today. People need to go to the market, talk to the farmer, ask about the production methods, whether they're certified organic or not. You can get a lot of information from people just talking about, you know, how they raise the food that they grow, whether it's meat, whether it's soy, whether it's grain, whether it's dairy, it doesn't matter. It's how it's grown that's important.
Customers aligned because they became the shoppers, but they also aligned as kind of having those skill sets to help, like, run a board or do a marketing campaign or do all the operational and governance thing a market's need to be successful, that, like, behind the scenes stuff. So the kind of the farmers and customers who have been traditionally aligned as, you know, producer consumer came together, like, stronger and tighter, but also kind of built a new relationship in terms of working together to run and govern the market.
And the engineering that that we intend to do with the regional market is to build out from the farmer, to build out a prosperous and sustainable environment for them to be able to sell to their to the local market of consumers or restaurants, whoever else might buy their product, and to place them at the center of the conversation rather than the intermediary which buys and sells their product.
I grew up in Hamilton, and when I was a kid we would go to the farmers market downtown in Hamilton, and it was just something we always did, something we always looked forward to. And then when my family and I moved to Peterborough now 16 years ago, we started to go to the farmers market every Saturday. So from a customer point of view, it's that touch point of just community, friends, and buying from farmers. We didn't create a farmers market, we created a community. And so the community of vendors came together. They're all supporting each other on social media. They're all watching out for each other. They're all helping out at each other's stalls. And it's bringing that culture together that is actually the successful ingredient for not for any enterprise, but specifically one where we're a social enterprise incubator of at least 50 other businesses. And the only way you can do that is create a culture of community, otherwise it'll fail.
I think the market is committed to maintaining those relationships and building policies into the fabric of the organization so that if when conflict arises, yeah, that we can deal with it in a way that's fair and transformative. It's like a family. You have to be intentional. You have to work at it. Mm-hmm. So I feel like we're in this very new, exciting honeymoon phase, but I also think that we're very committed to maintaining those relationships. And having, as vendors who experienced the loss, the cost of dysfunction in a market family, I think we're just going to be very intentional, mm-hmm, about making it work.